Hey, do you know what rapeseed is? In this video, I'm going to tell you the story of rapeseed and what we need to do to avoid getting diseases. In spring in England, you can see miles and miles of yellow fields. This is rapeseed crop. It is cultivated for oil. If you go to the supermarket anywhere in England, you will see shelves after shelves of rapeseed oil. Mousse, bread and other processed food that contain oil also has rapeseed in its content. Rapeseed has a high concentration of polyunsaturated fat, especially omega-3 fat. There is about 10% omega-3 in rapeseed. And that's why a lot of people advocate using rapeseed oil to increase our consumption of omega-3, which is one of the two essential fats our body requires. Now, in the US and Canada, it is called canola oil. The Canadian didn't think rapeseed was a good term to use, so they coined a new term, canola, which stands for Canadian oil. The high content of polyunsaturated fat in rapeseed oil, especially omega-3, unfortunately means that rapeseed oil is very unstable. It can be easily damaged during processing and also during heating up. In fact, since this oil is so unstable, even when left alone, it will turn rancid and become damaged anyway. If rapeseed oil is then used to make margarine, the damage is even more severe. The misunderstanding with this process is that the omega-3, which is high in content in rapeseed oil, consists mostly of damaged omega-3 in margarine and rapeseed oil that we use for cooking purposes. Now, when our body makes use of this damaged omega-3 for our cells, the cells start to malfunction, and this is the basis for the development of modern day degenerative diseases, including diabetes, heart disease, arthritis and even cancer. Rapeseed oil cannot be used in this way, and it is critical that we avoid damaged rapeseed oil that we find in abundance in margarine made from rapeseed oil, hydrogenated or halogenated rapeseed oil, or even any cooking oil which is high in polyunsaturated fat. Thank you.